saw a chain of light that seemed to be on. But to me, it was clear that chain continued to seem as a vehicle of self was approaching. The chain was in and the chain out. Whatever the reasons, he didn't share the other in the tower. I found security in the end, provided some of the time I wanted to come on. I needed that sense of family, camaraderie, and support. was a Taconic member, now in town for a month, and went to mass every morning. We certainly weren't famous, but in there we had rock star status. We had an album out, we were recording another. We really hit it off with a woman named Karen who worked there as a hostess. She was a bit older than I was, and we instantly took a liking to each other. She befriended me. She had traveled on tours with various band members of Deep Purple and Led Zeppelin. Upper rooms of the rock hierarchy. One of the walls in her apartment could have been in the music shop on 48th Street. Rows and rows of signs and 18 photos of the fans. We remained good friends, but had never seen eye to eye in our relationship during physical and later, after kids took off the lips. There was a purity to the system of the women. The women were part of the rhythm of rock and roll for a century to no possessiveness, no judgment. Each morning, back to Village Report. One day, I entered the studio and looked around. Where's my guitar? I asked. Wait, where's my amp? Oh, one of the studio reporters said. They already came and picked up all the gear. What? What are you talking about? Yeah, they came for it. They were here. Said they had come to pick it up. Thieves had dispensed with any high-tech scheme and just walked in and said they were a shipping company and made off with all our gear. His way out was through the front door. He got reimbursed and brought in the gear, and some of my guitars like a flying thing and custom made and never been replaced. Another day I was on my way to the studio when I rented the car, and a police car pulled up behind me and turned on its lights inside. I was wearing my usual off-duty uniform of hip upper jeans, really low rise, about a 3-inch zip, black overalls, ruffled woman's blouse, and jewelry, with my hair tumbled in long curls under my shoulders. In New York, this wasn't a big deal at the time. The officer walked over to the side of my car. License and registration, he said. It's a rental. I have no idea what the registration is, he said. It's a useful number. My wallet wasn't in my pocket. I left it, you don't have my wallet, he said. I must have left it at the hotel. In New York, not having my license with me, I've never been a problem. Well, then, officer, you're going to jail. I nearly pissed my pants and turned as white as a sheet. Jail? Look at me. You can't take me to jail with me like this. The cop looked at me and must have seen my terror. Be sure to carry your license next time, he said, motioning me to drive off. Note this out. Always. Kiss had slowly climbed into our home. Some of the shows to what they had helped us in before. We started to be special guests. The second band on the bill, the night was third. You know, the night in Cedar Rapids, REO Speedwagon, and special guest Kiss, plus surprise third act. Part of becoming successful was getting your own hotel room, and part of becoming successful was traveling the plane instead of by station. Sometimes when I was home for an off day, still crashing on my parents' house, a limo picked me up to take me to the airport. We had switched.